Thank you. Our next speaker is Mayank Chaturvedi from the Nensky Institute in Warsaw, Poland.
Good afternoon, everybody. So I'm a PhD student in Nensky Institute in Warsaw, and I'm working in laboratory of neurobiology. And my PhD project is about TIMFN-loaded nanoparticles, which we can use as a therapeutic strategy for neuroprotection. So I'll just give you a brief idea. What is this TIMFN? TIMFN is a protein, tissue inhibitor of matrix metalloprotease type 1. In short, we call it TIMFN. And this is an endogenous inhibitor of another protein called matrix metalloprotease 9, that is MMP9. So what I said, TIMFN is endogenous inhibitor of MMP9. And what this MMP9 does, it has been shown that in many neurodegenerative diseases, MMP9 increases, which causes excitotoxic neurodegeneration. So what we hypothesize that as TIMFN, which is an endogenous inhibitor of MMP9, it can inhibit MMP9 and it can give neuroprotective effects. But the problem with TIMFN is that it is a protein and it does not cross the blood-brain barrier. And also it has a very low bioavailability. So to deliver TIMFN, we thought we can use PLG nanoparticles in which the TIMFN will be entrapped in the PLG matrix. And to make them cross blood-brain barrier, we plan to coat them with polysorbate 80, that is twin 80, which is a surfactant. Because it has been shown that when we coat such nanoparticles with the polysorbate 80, they have been shown to cross blood-brain barrier. So I will not show you all the results. We have done in vitro and in vivo studies of these nanoparticles, and we have shown that these nanoparticles cross blood-brain barrier, and we have also shown that the polysorbate 80 coating is non-toxic. I will just show you the key results. So to check the neuroprotective effects, that is, can these nanoparticles protect the neurons from dying, we used hippocampal slice cultures. These are just brain slices. So in the brain slices, when we put kinic acid, which is an agent which causes neuronal toxicity and ultimately neurons are dying after it. And so we saw that MMP9 increases, which has been shown earlier many times. And as we put this kinic acid, we saw that the neurons were dying. The dead neurons were stained with red, probidium iodide. It's a staining for staining dead neurons. So when we did the same experiment, put kinic acid, we saw MMP9 release. And when we put our nanoparticles of TIMFN, we found that some sort of neuroprotection, a lesser neuronal death. So here I will conclude. And if you are interested in more seeing the in vitro and in vivo results of the data, I invite you to my poster number 12. Thanks a lot.